Yo, so you already know. We're taking a lesson from the big brother. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna wait these 2 minutes out real and make sure we don't get in trouble for nothing real interesting. About to touch on actually we can go I can go ahead and talk about the good shit real fast. But hey, so oops, sorry, good stuff right now. First of all, of course, we got King Crucial, the great in the building.
Yoda.
Bright and early, you know, so I think on the first conversation of the day. Oh man, so we're here to talk about a gentleman by the name of Martin Lindbergh, real briefly, you know what I'm saying? Just gonna touch on something I seen. What I will know is that he little man up. He got his first Grammy after 25 years in the game. They said he ended a 26-year drought. How huh, about share that? See, all I did was type his name in. You know what I'm saying? You know how I do. Pure search.
Right.
Right. So, boom. Now, first, we're going to talk about the individual we known for right this second. All right. Everything from 2022, everything is music related. Okay. Everything is music related. Okay. Because he's a DJ. His name is Master Fat Man. Right. Now, Master Fat Man got his first Grammy for let's see, some kind of fusion music or something.
Interesting.
But then the reason why he came up, coming congratulations to his first time award, you know what I'm saying, in a long career. He's Danish. He's from Denmark. Well, it says here that he died March 26 of 2019. What? Hold on. Wait a minute. All right. So anyway, so I don't know if anybody's seen this weirdness on the screen real quick. We're gonna figure out. We're gonna figure this out. But anyway, so I was on my Facebook, and I seen a post that said, "Search space movie 1992." I can't make this shit up. Okay, that's what I seen.
Right.
And normally I don't like feed into like the clickbait to go look at something, you know what I'm saying? And just 'cause
Right.
I've seen two people from two different circles. Two people from two different circles told me to look it up. And what I saw was a movie called Gay Niggers from Outer Space.
Oh shit, man.
So, first of all, I don't know what to say at all right now. Because that is the most ridiculous title I think I've ever seen. So I seen this, and I hit you up and let you know I want to talk about this. So I haven't seen anything at all. This is my first time looking at this stuff here. And we're definitely past the 2-minute mark. So we're going to go ahead and jump into this review done by somebody else. And they actually did this in January 11th of this year. And so obviously, when this man's name came up, people started looking him up to see who he was, to see who won this award. And then this now has resurfaced.
Okay.
And we're going to check this out.
Okay, so basically, I'm going to be doing a review of a film from 1992 called Game Niggas from Outer Space. This is a blaxploitation film, a Danish blaxploitation.
You can hear it fine.
Yeah, sounds good.
Which is pretty unusual for the 90s. You know, usually blaxploitation is a thing of the 70s / 80s. However, you know, this Danish guy just decided to make this movie. And yeah, it's a very interesting one. A friend recommended this to me a few days ago. And just from the title alone, I knew that it was something I was just going to have to check out and do a review on. So basically, it's a very short movie. It's only around 28 minutes long.
Possibly. Oh, I don't even want to hear the review, bro. I don't even want to hear it. I don't watch that shit if that bitch that short. I want to watch it if that bitch that short, dog. I don't even want to hear it, dog. I don't want no preemptive judgment when I watch this. I want a complete, unbiased, ingesting mind state. So... this is what I'm going to do. Just for the sake of the stream, and this be your platform, I'm going to step backstage, and you may be for when you're done with the review.
Why?
Because I don't want nobody's when I watch this. I don't want nobody else's thoughts or judgments before I watch it and give it my own.
Well, I'm going to go backstage too then. This is going to be, boy, this is going to be interesting.
It's only 28 minutes long. Yeah, we need to go ahead and pull that back, pull that up, and we'll start another live stream if need be.
I mean, it's about to play.
Well,
I'm about to play it right now.
Say less. Right here on the chaotic portal. Gay niggas.
Live. Yeah, you need to be backstage.
Too big to be another ship or meteor.
I'll make it through. The time has come for me to break out of the shell. I have to shout that I am coming out. I'm coming out. I want the world to know. I got to let it show. I'm coming out. I want the world to know. I got to let it show.
Captain, we got something on the radar.
What is it?
Well, sir, it's too big to be another ship or meteor. To me, it looks like...
Like what?
Like a planet.
A planet? Ein Planet!
A planet?
A planet! Get coordinates, Ildo, and give me a diacom in 5 minutes. And Shrool, check the mental analysis machine.
There, we'll be able to do an ultra sweep over in 25 seconds.
Okay, everybody. Ultra sweep over in 18 seconds. Arminas, activate canopus sensor and trans power system. Ildo?
4, 3, 2, 1.
Ultra sweep over.
Ultra sweep over. Ultra sweep over.
Okay, Chief, I got a decom. What we have here is a planet called Earth. There is life on its own and a lot of water. It seems rather primitive. And, sir, there is something terrible going on down there.
Take it easy, Ildo. Don't paint the devil on the wall.
But, sir, there is, pardon me, female creatures on the planet.
Braun Kreaturen!
Female creatures!
Female creatures!
Female creatures!
Okay, calm down. We've got to check this out. It might be dangerous, but it's our duty. Arminas, put us through to our planet. I got to talk to the headquarters. Now! Hello, hello! Headquarters, come in, come in! Here is Captain B. Dick. P-code 2940018 on Discovery ship Ring Musculatoris 2. Come in. Come in.
Hello, Captain B. Dick. This is the president of the Federation of Intergalactic Game Planets. What we have here is highly classified A material. We haven't dealt with a case of this magnitude in many years. I just got your diacom, and our mainframe computer doesn't respond. I even talked to the Council of Wise Men, and believe it or not, even they can't give us any useful information about the strange female creatures. I'm afraid we'll have to get in closer contact.
You mean, send a man down there?
Yeah, we have to be sure. But take care, it might be dangerous. Good luck, CBD.
Everybody listen. We've got to beam somebody down to get more precise information. Ildo, prepare beaming. And Sergeant Shave Balls, activate Stellar Reference and remove Light Shield 2. Arminas, go in the relaxing room. I want to talk to you.
Yes, sir!
Yo.
Yo.
I'm having a real interesting time with this.
Yeah, bro. I can't watch this shit, dog. Fuck everything I said. I think I'd rather watch the review. Oh, God, bro. Like, yo, yeah. Turn that shit all the way off, man. Dig into who put that shit together, who put the money and shit behind that shit.
That's the funny part. When you look at, man, Lee, all right, so look, I'm going to show it to you anyway. The movie. I'm going to show you the where I found the movie information at is a familiar source to all of us. We know what website this is.
What, IMDb?
Mm-hmm. Look at that popularity rate. And it's giving a 6 out of 10, my nigga. So like I said, the only reason why this even seemed to have resurfaced because this man won an award post-mortem, obviously.
Well, check this out. That seems like a blueprint of sorts to the shit what we see in the movies, what we see today. How they putting that's crazy. I want to immediately erase that whole last 15 minutes up out of my memory.
Yeah. 6,000. Almost 7,000 people voted and gave it rating.
In my 30 years of living, I've never heard of this movie.
Yeah, this is not
you told me about it.
This is not something that would have hit any of our radars in the normal. So, like I said, somebody had to be paying attention to the names and looked it up, and somehow it trickled into us regular folk, because this is something they probably would have wanted to keep quiet forever. Okay.
The title alone, man.
Take that to mom. Take it to mom. Take it to mom. Yeah, man, that's why. So you want to watch the review?
Nah, man, I'm quite done with that shit, dog. I ain't got too much to say on it. I'm disgusted.
Terrifying, YT. It's amazing to me. Oh man, I don't know what to say, man, because I don't remember. I don't know how the Dutch feel about us in general. You know what
well,
I'm saying?
Well, maybe back then, why it didn't come on our radar is because maybe it was considered an adult film.
Especially in the States, you know, they kind of always been, you know, taboo.
So I just want to throw that perspective out there. That's a thought. So, you know, I just can't see the production of this movie being anything except for that.
I mean, 28 minutes. How much could the money could that have been? That didn't look. I mean, the most money they spent was the set.
Yeah, it was very low pro.
Man, so in this one. So that this can stand on its own, but if we gonna talk about anything else as serious, I'm gonna do it on another broadcast. But I just wanted to bring that to your attention. Such foolishness slipped through our fingers. You know what I'm saying?
Niggas went all the way past.
Yeah, man. All right, how many years? Oh man, 92. My little sister was born in 90, bro.
I was born in 90.
We missed 30 years. This movie slipped under the freaking radar for 30 years.
That's crazy, bro. Like I said, I was born in 90 and I watch movies. Like,
now, question. Do you think his career would have been what it was if that movie would have made it into international popularity or knowledge?
What is his career?
He's supposedly a heavy... See, okay, so now let's get back to the topic, I guess. The topic is Mr. Morton.
Right.
Who is Mr. Morton?
Sound like a Disney character.
His first name is Morton, last name is Lindbergh.
Definitely sound like a Disney character. Is this a black man?
No, sir.
And he's what to this movie?
He's the director and the writer. Look at this. Morten Lindbergh is a Norwegian sound engineer and music producer specializing in classical music productions. As a producer and an engineer, he held the record for most Grammy nominations without a win with 28 through 2019 until 2020 when he won his first Grammy. Okay, and no, he is not dead. He is still very much alive. His Grammy award is Grammy Best Immersive Audio Album. Okay. This is okay. So in the beginning, I was absolutely incorrect with the Wikipedia I was reading earlier. This man here is still alive, born in 1970, makes him 51 years old. He is from Norway.
And that explains why the movie wasn't big in the United States. I don't think that was an American movie, bro.
No, it was not at all. No, the beginning of the review says that it's a Danish movie, which I guess the people from Norway are Danish, it was like blaxploitation. He said, which was more popular in the 70s. So he was surprised that this even surfaced in the 90s. And so it tells me this is. It's not much about him. We can go to his Facebook page, though.
I mean, at the end of the day, like I said, the people who end up exploiting people through videography and film and everything are the ones that get the Grammys. They're the ones who get the awards because they're going to cause the most controversy.
Hey, so remember, so you know what we be talking about all the time? About the prosthetics?
Okay.
So this guy here and this guy here?
Mm-hmm.
Both had the same government name.
Master Fat Man.
Uh-huh. The difference here is there's a middle name for him in order to distinguish the difference. But they have the same name.
He's Danish.
He from Norway. He from Denmark.
Okay, there's this movie on Netflix that came across my radar, right?
Mm-hmm.
And since you jumped down this rabbit hole, I want you to check that out. And then we'll start our next episode. But it's not even a movie. It's a Netflix series. And it's crazy, bro. Like, the way this dude explained his actions and everything, I'm about to tell you. I'm building up to it. Let me build my suspense.
I hate that. I hate that suspense.
Because I got to find out the name of the movie anyways.
Oh, I'll shoot the bad guy before he finished telling me the plan. I don't sit and wait.
Yeah, I'm trying to find out the name of the movie that I watched. I can't find it. Hold up. It was called Squid Game.
Oh, listen. I just got on. Listen. Me and G just got on Squid Game, my dude.
Finish that shit out, then I go follow into this conversation.
But I'm saying
it's going to be self-explanatory. Did you finish it?
Heck no, man. We just started yesterday because I seen a TikTok. Somebody on TikTok told me I was sleeping on it.
Yeah, so you is. Yeah, nah, you
I was like, I'm watching the weird shit, man.
Nigga, I wouldn't even be on them motherfucking live stream if I was still watching that show.
Man.
For real, that bitch. Hey, I'm telling you, bro, watch that thing.
Watch
that thing. Watch that thing right now.
Let's see. Shout out King Crucial the Great, the official KingCrucial.com.
You already know. Shout out to Time Management, get your credit repair done, and you know, all that good stuff. You know, all the good stuff. You gotta have good credit, buy homes, get cars, everything else like that.
Right.
And you know, ain't nothing like cleaning your face.
You got delayyourself.com for all your business and lifestyle needs, tutoring, consulting, all the good stuff, and
my laptop got corrupted, bro. Somebody corrupted my shit, dog. So that'd be out of commission.
What's up with the next season of KTP then?
Oh shit, boy. Postponed till further ado.
Or are we gonna get it
popping? Till then, we gonna get the chaotic portal up and running. You know, we're gonna keep this thing going. And maybe after we hit 30, 40 videos on your channel, then we'll probably be ready for KTP kick back up.
But so we're gonna prep for the next episode. That way we get you a chance to get on, you know what I'm saying? We ain't see him in class today, but he probably would have bugged out. He probably would have been mad at me for playing that today.
Oh, well, Geechee would have tapped out as soon as the title popped up. What the fuck? Oh, hell no. I can't adjust no shit like this.
Hey,
soon as I said, I want to watch it. And then you started playing that bit. I immediately regretted it. I was like, you caught me in the comments, man. Listen. I heard the babes. I'm like, what the fuck? Oh, no. This is some indoctrination shit. But yeah, my bad, bro.
Listen, I really wasn't one to watch. If I wasn't on YouTube trying, you know what I'm saying, working on my, my setup and my content or whatnot, bro, I would have left it alone. But I wanted to see if there was any kind of, You know, but the lesson I got from it though is that we got to be careful of who we're praising or who's getting praised. We need to look at these people and see what they're really doing and what they're really about. If he thought it was a good idea to put that movie out, what else do you think is a good idea?
All right, finish watching Squid Games, my boy. You'll see. It'll explain so much, even about this situation. Finish watching that shit.
But all right, you want shit. Much love. We gonna be on the next episode of Chaotic Portal. Hold up, I gotta run my banners.